Okay, good morning. So welcome to the fifth deep learning workshop in Tokyo. So my name is Masashi Sugiyama. I'm one of the organizers of the workshop. So then let me briefly talk about the workshop. So this is the fifth round of the deep learning workshop. So we try to bring together leading scientists in deep learning related areas within machine learning, AI, mathematics, statistics, and neuroscience. Then, so we want all the presenters to talk about your recently published work as well as work in progress, and also share your vision and perspective for the field. And this is the fifth round, and the first round was also in Japan, Shonan, 4 years ago. Then so Italy, USA, Germany, then so fifth round again in Japan. And this is the program. So the first talk will start from 9:30, so I just spent 10 minutes or so for opening, and then so we have a lot of talks. Then tomorrow afternoon, we have an excursion. So unfortunately, the weather prediction is rainy, but hopefully we have some sunshine tomorrow. So then one change of the program here is the last day in the morning. So the talk was canceled. So my current plan is to start from 10, start from coffee break. Maybe this is fine for the last day. So then the organizers are so Pierre Baudy here, and then Kenji Fukumizu somewhere. Then Naonori Ueda and myself. And this workshop is supported by Riken Center for Advanced Intelligence Project and NVIDIA, Denso, and NEC. So they are sponsors. So then the next 5 minutes, let me introduce our Riken Center for Advanced Intelligence Project briefly. So Riken founded this center for AIP 2 years ago. So this is supported by the Ministry of Education in Japan. So that means actually we can do fundamental research. And this is project is designed for 10 years. So we can really spend 10 years for pursuing fundamental research. And we are given 5 missions in our center. The first one is really fundamental research. So we try to develop next generation AI technology, and we try to understand deep learning, and we try to go beyond deep learning. So then the second challenge is to accelerate scientific research. So we want to support like fundamental scientific research that are particularly common in Japan. For example, stem cell research, iPS cells are actually quite important in Japan. And then manufacturing, material science, so these are quite popular in Japan. And we are working with those research centers and really accelerating their research. Then the third one is to solve socially critical problems. Like Japan is quite well known for like super aged society, so we need to really help elderly people, elderly healthcare. And also disaster is quite a big issue in Japan, and infrastructure management, so these are big social problems in Japan. And we are working with public research centers working on these issues and support their activities. Then the fourth one is the study of ethical, legal, and social issues of AI. So I think most of us are like technology scientists, but still, like once AI technologies are developed, deployed in the real world, we have a lot of ethical problems and really legal problems. So in our center, we also include like ethics researchers and even lawyers in our center and discuss the like, influence of AI spread in society. Then the last one is human resource development. So nowadays, hiring AI researchers is really difficult. Then we need to basically educate and develop researchers and engineers. So we are doing that like globally, both in like industrial and academic ways. So then this is the current organization of our AIP center. So I'm director, and Naonori Ueda is the deputy director. And we have senior advisor, so Takeo Kanade from CMU. And we have special advisors of Kazuyuki Aihara from University of Tokyo. So he's working on mathematical engineering. Then Mitsuo Kawato from ATL, so he's a neuroscientist. Then Masaru Kitsuregawa from University of Tokyo and NII. So he's a big data database person. Then we have 3 research groups. So one is called Generic Technology Research Group. So researchers in this group are basically machine learning, optimization, mathematics people. So they do fundamental research. So then the second one is called Goal-Oriented Technology Research Group. So we have a lot of like kind of applied researchers, but still they are based on fundamental stuff. So they are bridging real-world people and fundamental people. Then the last one is AI in Society Research Group. So here we have like ethics researchers and law professors, and they are discussing like ethics and law issues of AI. So at this point, we have 88 full-time researchers in our center, and then we have more than 300 part-time affiliated members. And to do AI research, we need good computational resources. And last year, we bought 24 DGX-1 GPU machines, so that's actually half precision, 4 petaflops. And that was actually ranked number 4 in the Green 500 list last year. It's 10 gigaflops per watt. But already almost 90% of the resources are used by many researchers, and it's quite full. So we decided to further reinforce our GPU machines, and now it will be actually now under development, but it will be about 54 petaflops within this month. So this is, I think, quite good. And this is shared by like, only our researchers. So some young students are actually quite happy to run many programs on this GPU server. So here is like AIP kind of headquarters. So we have a big office there. But also our offices are distributed over Japan because we have team leaders from different universities, like from Hokkaido to Kyushu, so distributed over Japan. And also we have a lot of overseas partners like in North America, Europe, and Asia, Middle East, and Oceania. So we are communicating with these people and try to have like more people exchange and collaboration. And to accelerate people communication, so we are actually running an internship program. So we invite like PhD students from your universities, basically. So hopefully the length could be 3 months or even longer. Some students want to stay 1 year. This is also fine. We can basically support their air ticket to Japan and from Japan. And also we can provide sufficient housing allowance, and we can also help find an economical apartment. Also, we provide commuting allowance and daily allowance for students. But not only for students, but also we are happy to accept visiting faculties and researchers. So this is even better. So we are very happy to have you here again. Okay, then, so finally, we are back to the program. So the first talk is by Professor Kunihiko Fukushima. So we are very happy to invite him. So, okay, welcome.